Much of my life, I was under this strange mindset that all you have to do is give somebody a chance and they will develop into a great human being. I have recently learned that's not the case. Well, it's not for me to judge, to say great or not great, it's not that. But there's something that I cannot really put into words. And I believe there are two types of people. Whether or not you are Rh negative, there is a predisposition, of course, blood types and personality traits. But I also have realized that you can spend all your... Okay, there are people who use their gifts and those who don't. There are those who give up and those who fight. When somebody fights, but fights in the right way, not in an insane way, not in a self-destructive way, not in an, you know, it's a great thing to see. It's something I like to be around, that kind of energy. And it's not always about, you know, how will it end? That's not always visible. I used to think, and I still do, that I can tell when looking at people to a degree where they are headed, you know, I can pick up on that. But I also know in my case, I have had so many turning points, but I'm sure it'll be all right. Things will be good. And I can pick that up from other people as well, even though temporary at times, there seems to be setbacks where people show their negative emotions, anything that accumulates. You don't always know, are they at their breaking point or not? Are they about to be done? Are they about to be discredited and forever discarded and misrepresented without having a second turn at setting the record straight? Life is really short. I used to think it isn't. And actually, life is longer time-wise than I anticipated, I believe. You know, I had this dream when I was maybe 15 that I'm going to be 96 years old. And at the time, you know, when I told people in my 20s, they'd say, dude, you smoke, you do this, you do, are you crazy? You're never, now I'm like, yeah. When, who knows, man, when by the time I am 96, life expectancy will probably 110. Who knows? I'm serious, it's possible. You see, imagine all of the things that people die of being somehow gone. Imagine there being no more cancer. Imagine so many things being gone. Imagine that. Seriously. I always thought about that. I always thought about when I look at life expectancy, 70. When I was a kid, it was 70. It was actually like 69 point something. And I always said, isn't that something? What about all the things, you know, I understand. I always said I would like to see a chart of people who just die of natural causes, as they put it so nicely, right? Natural causes means you live a healthy life, you don't have any special diseases, you don't have a stroke, you don't have a heart attack, you don't have this, you don't have that. You eat like you should, but you just fade away. You just die. Your body, you're just done. You know what I mean? At what age would that be if you were living in perfect conditions? I'm talking about you have the diet that is perfect for you. You live by the ocean. Plenty of clean oxygen, zero pollution, nothing. You are happy. You have, well, let's call it an Rh negative community. People who are how about this? People who share your blood type, be it A negative, be it B negative, be it O. Or let's just say the ideal people who are the types of people that you are not likely to have miscommunication with. Imagine your ideal life, your ideal situation. I'm that serious about that. I thought about this so many times, you know. I don't like distortions, and this is for entertainment purposes only, because I don't know anything. But you know, when you see the distortion of factualities, just now I've read that in the, you know, the magnesium thing. Have you seen my article? Have you seen it? It is shown that vegetables, I believe, have lost over the last 100 years 80 to 90% of its minerals or magnesium levels. That means you don't get what people used to. It means you are ailing and don't even know it. Well, again, I don't know anything. So, having said that, what do you think? Under perfect conditions, no unhappiness, no stress, anything. Live a cool life. You got what you need, right? You don't have anything maybe extra. You're stuck on your island, right? But in a nice house with air condition, and with air condition that has no asbestos in it. The perfect air condition. Or maybe no air condition, but a nice house with a cool natural breeze. You know, the wind blowing through or something like that. Would it be 200 years? What do you think? What do you think? I mean, isn't it amazing when you look at people, even when they become like 110 years old, imagine all of the pollution that's going into their lungs, all of the processed foods, artificial chemical flavors, all of that stuff. How much of an impact do you think it has? Do you think without that they would be even better off? Do you think they had stress, without which they would have even lived longer? You see, I don't look at it. I never look at life as is, because even when I was a kid, I felt like this is it. This is it. This is really it. So when people say evaluate things, I'm always thinking in the back of my mind how things could be. I can't help it. And so I am now losing my track again. Forgot how I was going to talk about. And I think the best thing I can do at these moments is really stop the video. And thank you guys for watching.